Wetseber, sieningsvideo's vir prinsessies wat in bediening staan, week 31. Mag God hierdie week ons die getuienisfabriek maak. Mag ons soveel getuienisse produseer, waarmee ons prinsessies kan inspireer. Ek glo werklik in die waarde en die krag van oorspronklike getuienisse versus gepreekte versies. Een getuienis kan ons dat lewendig voel en vir ons 'n doggy bag type van 'n lesie leer. Something we can take home. Mag God elkeen van ons spanlede werklik hierdie week aanraak en vir ons leer hoe om in die getuienisfabriek te gaan werk. Jy weet al die liedjie van Ghostbusters, Who You Gonna Call Ghostbusters. Mag ons ook so algemene ritme en lese deur ons land rondswaai. Mag die gees dit versprei soos 'n aangename geur, dat wanneer 'n prinsesie 'n pleister benodig op 'n emosionele wond, dat dit sal wees, Who You Gonna Call, Bethseber. Mag ons werklik goed beleef hierdie jaar, dat die navraag en die oproepe, sy getuienisse, so radikaal sal instroom. Givers need to set a limit, because takers don't know how to. Mag God ons dagelijks leer om nieuwe limits en grense in plek te stel, zodat mensen niet meer onnodiglik van ons vat nie. Mag God vir ons unieke maniere gee om te onderskei tussen wie is dit net 'n teiker. Ek het al van tevore gehoor van mense wat demone kan reik. Dalk is hoe hy dit vir jou kan leer. Ek besef gewoonlik iemand is 'n teiker wanneer ek baie moeg voel nadat ek met hulle gekuier het. En mag God vir ons nuwe unieke maniere leer van hoe om grense te bou. Dalk is dit om 'n limiet te plaas op die tyd wat ons investeer in hulle in. Dalk is dit om hulle Timbuktu te stuur. Maar mag God vir ons nuwe maniere leer om daardie grense in plek te stel. Dalk is dit net dood eenvoudig om te leer om meer nee te sê. Op die onderwerp van mense laat ons moeg voel na die tyd. Hierdie video van Rob Bell het my soveel insig gegee op die onderwerp.
Where we're headed, we could have all sorts of answers. And about 125 years ago, scientists were able for the first time to identify an actual atom. And there was this moment of we've got it. But then they developed slightly more sophisticated technology and realized actually you can take apart an atom, and an atom is made of smaller bits and pieces called particles. But then they developed even more sophisticated technology and realized actually those particles, you can take them apart, and those particles are made of even smaller particles. Then they developed even more sophisticated technology and realized you can actually take apart those particles. At this point, they've been able to identify at least 150 subatomic particles. And when you get down at the subatomic quantum particle level of materiality of the world, things get very, very, very weird very fast. They have identified subatomic particles that come into existence for a billionth of a second and then disappear, and they don't know where they come from and they don't know where they go. They have observed subatomic particles that leave at point A and appear at point B without traveling the distance in between. They have identified subatomic particles that leave at point A and travel to point B, but actually travel every single possible route from point A to point B, and only reveal which route they actually took when they're observed. Some of you have Apple Rainbow Death Wheel right now. You're just totally locked up, like. Now, as they kept going farther and farther and farther in, because forever, of course, the question was, where is the end of the universe? Like, do you at some point get to the outer edges of the universe and then you and Jim Carrey walk through a door, right? That was always the question. How big is the thing? But quantum physics raised this fascinating question, how small is the thing? Can you just endlessly take it apart? And what they're now saying essentially is that at the smallest particle level, particles are essentially bits and pieces of energy, and an atom is essentially a relationship of energy. So you, my brothers and sisters, are a very, very complicated, several billion times over relationship of energy, interacting with other relationships of energy. Wood, concrete, steel, glass, rocks, trees, rivers, frogs. Reality at its core is energy in relationship. You ever been with someone and they walked away and you thought, dear God, that person just took 3 years off my life? Maybe they did. Oh, whenever I'm with them, it's so draining. Yeah, it could be. Like, no, actually draining. I feel like they just plugged into me and sucked the life out of me. Maybe that's exactly what was happening. Because in the modern world, we were taught that we are self-contained, autonomous human beings, correct? And so we had a conversation in which we exchanged words, and then we went our separate ways. But who knows what else is going on in the space between you? How